ए.आर. रहमान ये महज एक नाम नहीं, इस शख्सियत को याद करते ही कुछ ऐसे गीत याद आते हैं जो हम कभी नहीं भुला सकते। वो इसलिए क्योंकि उनके हर गीत में नएपन का एहसास होता है। पेश है सुरों के जादूगर ए.आर. रहमान से ईटीसी बॉलीवुड बिजनेस की खास बातचीत।
रहमान जी, थैंक यू सो मच फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस ऑन आवर शो। सबसे पहला सवाल, एकेडमी अवार्ड्स के बाद जिंदगी बदल गई होगी और बेहतर हो गई होगी। लाइफ मस्ट हैव चेंज्ड फॉर बेटर।
यस, इन अ वे लॉट ऑफ थिंग्स ओपनड अप, बट आल्सो देयर टू मच ऑफ एडोलेशन एंड यू डोंट गेट द टाइम, यू आर जस्ट क्रेविंग फॉर द टाइम टू गो एंड वर्क इन द स्टूडियो। देयर आर अ लॉट ऑफ फेलिसिटेशंस एंड पीपल आर जस्ट वांट टू मीट यू एंड you don't meet them, they feel offended.
Yes, they feel offended, yes.
And you have to do, now we have to balance both. So it was good, I went 2 months to LA to finish this, one of the scores I've been doing in Hollywood. Right. And came back, and so I was much fresher this time.
Right. But jab aap aise awards jeete hain, jo ultimate award mana jata hai, Oscars, Academy Awards, uske baad pressure aapke kandho pe aur hota hai to perform, to live up to those expectations.
I never in my life wanted to be unnatural. I don't want to be a dual personality. I am what I am. From the beginning, I've been trying to, you know, do the best of my ability, be honest to my work. So that's what has brought, I guess, to that level of Oscars and stuff. And people do see the record of what this guy has done and stuff like that. So, of course, now there are better opportunities to work with more talented people and team and musicians and studios and so many things. So, on the whole level, when you make a choice to work with a better team, your whole level of work goes beyond, I guess. Right. And so that's a good factor, I guess.
Right. You know, but चूंकि आपको ये award से सम्मानित किया गया है, इतने बड़े award से, तो कई लोगों को ये feeling है कि शायद अब आप हिंदी फिल्में अब कम करेंगे, आपका ध्यान अब west की तरफ होगा, Hollywood फिल्मों की तरफ होगा। क्या ये सही है?
And the Tamil people are saying that I've left Tamil people and then gone to Hindi. No, I want to do what excites me. At the same time, respect my following, the people who have made me, you know, who have loved me.
Right.
So it's never would be an opportunity to ditch them or anything. But I want to go further to learn a lot of things, and you know, I also work with like big budget films and you know big vision films like. Right off, just doing a comedy in Hollywood, but it's a very important comedy, and it's got Vince Vaughn, John Favreau, and it's an interesting movie. And then, of course, Blue, which is probably India's underwater film, which is again a very exciting film.
Right.
And in Tamil, of course, I'm doing an animation film and doing Shankar and Rajinikanth's film and all those things.
Right.
So there's a balance, which is
right. So now you have to strike a balance between Mumbai, Chennai, and Los Angeles.
And London.
And London, yes, of course.
No, but the spirit of music is the same, you know. And what's good is the timing of when, of which I started my school, Kent Music Conservatory, and now when I come back here, it's always a frustration that there's no orchestra here, full orchestra to record and speed up things, to execute music, you know, faster and more efficiently with more dynamics and more quality. So that school is slowly coming up and you're seeing a lot of promise in the kids. And going to Hollywood, winning the Oscars has helped the school in a great way.
Okay.
To get recognition and external help for, you know, getting teachers and awareness for the future of music, I guess.
Right. But tell me one thing, मैं ये बहुत curious हूँ जानने के लिए, क्योंकि आप west में भी हैं और आप हिंदुस्तान में भी अपना एक पैर रखा है अपना, कितना फर्क है हमारे music में और उनके music में?
I love music as a total thing.
Okay.
And for me, that's been my philosophy. I do appreciate every nuance of Carnatic, Hindustani, Western classical, folk music, African music, Sufi music. So, but every music has something in it. And I know that everybody didn't be like this. I'm like this.
Okay.
So, and because I think the way I grew up and the way I was doing different things at different points of my life, which made me forced to learn a lot of things.
आप फिल्मों के मामले में बेहद चूजी हैं. तो ऐसी क्या बात थी ब्लू में, इस फिल्म में, जो आपने हाँ कहा?
Well, I didn't, in the beginning, I didn't accept the movie. I thought, oh, some movie is happening. But I could see the passion of the director, and he has done stuff before. It's always, when somebody comes does something for the first time, he is probably 10 times more careful and more passionate.
Right.
And at the same time, he could also be an inexperienced person to do so many things. But here, there's a person like Tony who was so persistent on me doing the music. And then I was seeing shots and how he was handling things, which convinced me, and how the whole Ashtavinayak trusted him so much. So the whole, and all the actors trusted him very much. And I think it's, and most of my film big hits were first timers, like Shankar.
Right.
Or in the first time I did, most of the Hindi films also, they were like, of course, second film, but Rakesh Mehra, and it, you know, it was always like an attempt which is discovering, people discovering themselves.
Right.
In making the movies or in a subject.
Right.
So that's even more interesting than tried and trusted people who are like, oh, you know, I know that it's going to make a hit. So that's boring.
Right.
The also the risk of having a failure, you know, and with a team is much more exciting. That so we do it all together, and when it succeeds, you get probably 10 times more happiness, I guess.
But you know, अगर ब्लू की बात करते हैं तो ब्लू एक अंडरवाटर फिल्म है और इसमें काफी स्टंट्स हैं, काफी एक्शन है. ऐसी फिल्म में क्या म्यूजिक का स्कोप रहता है?
The music role in this film is really different. It's not two people, you know, running around trees or
yes.
Because here music is playing a very entertaining kind of a thing. At the same time, Abbas, who wrote the lyrics, came up with a great concept of a song. And that's in the second half, which I never even thought of could exist in this movie. And that's become a favorite song of everybody.
That's
called Bhula Tujhe.
Okay, tell me one thing. इसमें आपने Kylie Minogue से भी गाना गवाया है. Now ये idea किसका था? एक international artist को लेके आना, उनसे एक हिंदुस्तानी फिल्म में गाना गवाना.
I think both the producer and Tony had this idea of having a international celebrity.
Right.
It's also bridging both the worlds. You know, when the whole of the West were talking about Snoop Dogg and the other film,
right?
Singers King, and then I think that probably led a lot of good vibes, and this is probably the follow-up, I guess.
Right, but इसका कारण एक शायद ये भी होता है कि today Indian films, Hindustani films जो हैं वो they are looking beyond the borders of India. They want to appeal to the international audiences also. और अगर आप एक international artist को ले लेते हैं तो it becomes easier.
Yeah, in a way, I would say that's one of the points. But also, I think our films, we have a great tradition of films.
Okay.
There are a lot of great films made in the last 100 years.
Okay.
And then it's not a crime to expand.
Yes.
So when you expand, a lot of people love, in Russia, people are crazy about a film, Mauritius, Morocco, and so many different, Iran, and in the East, like Malaysia, Singapore, people are, you know, wild about our films and our stars and music and everything. So why not take that extra step? Positively and you know honestly and then get that.
Okay, you know मैंने आपकी off late, in fact काफी time पहले से आपकी repertoire में, आपके body of work में मैंने एक बात notice की है कि आप new music direct, new singers से काफी गाने गवाते हैं, नए लोगों को बहुत break देते हैं. Established जो singers हैं, उनके साथ आपने बहुत कम कर दिया है काम करना, ये सही है?
Well, it is true, but it's unfortunately I do my songs instinctively.
Okay.
And I call them, can you come tomorrow?
Okay.
So sometimes they are on a tour. It's like, you know, Sonu Nigam was supposed to sing Guzarish, that song.
Right.
He sang the first draft of lyrics and he had gone to New Jersey. So when he came back, Javed Ali has already sang the song. And it was a solo song in a way. But then everybody liked it and then he couldn't change it because Amir was so particular about lip syncing and all this stuff. So there are certain, you know, certain issues about schedules and things involved in these things. It's not a deliberate reason. Oh, I don't want old singers. No, I love them. Like they provide so much of value to a song.
Yes.
But at the same time, there's a lot of other things involved into.
Right.
Sometimes we wait for a singer.
Okay.
Sometimes you know the singer like Naresh Iyer, who sang Rubru.
Yeah.
Was I was so tired that day, so that he sang the song. So you sing it, and then I like the song. I said I don't want to sing it. You sound good. So sometimes, you know, decisions are made like that. And then you got national award for that song.
Yes, very true.
Which is
great actually. But aapko lagta hai jab aap ek established singer ka, aapne Sonu Nigam ka zikr kiya. He has sung so many songs. He is a very good singer. But at the same time, ye ek naya singer hota hai. To kahin na kahin ek rawness hoti hai. Unhe train karna padta hai. Aur shayad aapke naam se, aapka jo naam mein jo wazan hai, usse shayad wo ghabrate honge, nervousness feel karte honge.
Initially they are, and then they become like friends.
Okay.
And because I'm also a beginner, I feel.
Okay.
And if you act, oh, I'm Dr. A.R. Rahman, same for me. They'll all be shivering. But it's a very friendly atmosphere in the studio. Okay. Everybody is treated equal. There are no servants, no bosses. It's everybody's equal. An artist, the boss.
Very true. Okay. Aapne, you know, चूंकि अभी आपकी नई नेक्स्ट रिलीज हिंदी में ब्लू है, इससे यही उम्मीद की जा रही है कि जय हो के बाद आपका हर गाना उसी लेवल का होगा. डू दीज एक्सपेक्टेशन स्केयर यू?
इट ऑलवेज इट बिकम अ हैबिट ऑफ पीपल एक्सपेक्टिंग
राइट
एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम ऑनेस्टली वी ट्राई हार्ड समटाइम्स वी सैटिस्फाई देम समटाइम्स वी डोंट बट एवरी टाइम इट देयर इज एन ऑनेस्ट अटेम्प्ट इन सैटिस्फाइंग पीपल.
ऑस्कर्स के बाद कितना फर्क पड़ता है आज आपको लगता है आपके लिए, आपने ही या कई और हिंदुस्तानी टेक्नीशियन थे उनके लिए डोर्स हैव ओपन्ड अप इन हॉलीवुड, आपको लगता है?
इट इज अ रिस्पांसिबिलिटी. आई मीन नाउ देयर इज अ लेजिटिमेसी एंड सेइंग ओह इंडियंस हैव गॉट ऑस्कर्स टू एंड चाइनीज गॉट ऑस्कर्स यू नो कपल ऑफ इयर्स बैक
राइट
एंड सो देयर इज अ यू नो द लुकिंग डाउन अपॉन अ कंडेसेंडिंग थिंग इज गॉन.
यस
एनीथिंग मे कम फ्रॉम इंडिया इज अ थिंग. सो it's much better than thinking that oh we have to go hit stay in New York or LA and hang out there and probably piggyback on somebody else's thing. No need. Now if you're good enough, you're spotted and people take you. Everything is being noted now. Every move is being noted, every film or every song is being played on iTunes and you know people are listening to all this stuff. You have to be more careful.
Very true. But aapko हिंदुस्तानी मीडिया ही नहीं बल्कि अभी वर्ल्ड में भी लोग ट्रेंड सेटर मानते हैं. हाउ डू यू फील अबाउट दिस?
इट वाज नॉट वेरी कॉन्शियस फॉर मी, इट वाज अ कॉन्शियस अटेम्प्ट. इट वाज आउट ऑफ फ्रस्ट्रेशन दैट आई वाज इन द मूवीज प्लेइंग फॉर डिफरेंट पीपल एंड आई फेल्ट सो बोर्ड दैट व्हेन आई डिड म्यूजिक आई वांटेड टू हैव फन एंड सो आई डिडंट वांट टू डू एनीथिंग व्हिच आई हैव बीन थ्रू. आई वांटेड टू गो टू अ न्यू एरिया टू रिजुवेनेट माय पैशन एंड I never knew that it would be a trend-setting thing. I never intended it that way.
Okay, how do you manage this? I mean, aapki har jo dhun hai, aapki har track hai, it sounds very fresh. Chahe wo Dilli 6 ka track ho, chahe wo Blue ka. How do you bring that individuality? How do you bring that freshness to every song?
First of all, we all like to criticize what is coming first, okay. Before you guys tear it apart. We first put it around, it does not sound good. So make sure that it really sounds good for people to say, no, it sounds good. Rather than, yeah, it doesn't sound good. So make them feel that it's not good in the beginning. And a lot goes into it. A lot goes into it. There's so many times you work so hard on something and scrap it. So it's not right for this film, or, you know. But you have to take it with a pinch of salt, I guess.
Very true, very true. But when you work with the first-time director, like, say, Anthony D'Souza, who is Blue's director, चूंकि आपने इतना हासिल कर लिया है और ऑस्कर के बाद आपकी एक अलग ही रुतबा, आपका एक अलग पोजीशन है, तो क्या वो आपके सामने कुछ कह पाते हैं, अपनी ओपिनियंस दे पाते हैं?
Any true artist would only believe in the truth, not in flattery. So that's what I want from my directors too. I don't want, oh, you're Oscar, whatever you do will be good.
Right.
That's not the thing at all. And we want to make sure that without all the strings attached, is it sounding good?
Right.
And is it right for the film? Because then it's a big responsibility. It's a big budget film, and then we hold responsible for that to the people for our own credibility.
Okay, are you planning something of your own? जो आप जो film से तालुकात नहीं रखता हो, but non-film हो, जो आप West में appeal दिखाना चाहेंगे? कुछ are you planning some album or something of that sort?
I just did an album for one of the Nokia phone company where we just. It's called Connections for the phone. It's a very new concept of providing content on a phone.
Okay.
So I was just thinking what would be right for a phone, you know, a person who has a phone and who could listen on headphones. So we did tracks like meditation tracks, jazz fusion, and like an upbeat track and instrumental tracks and mood stuff. So it was fun doing that.
कितना क्रेडिट देते हैं विजुअल्स को? आज की तारीख में हम एक जमाना था जब हम कहते थे हम सिर्फ गाने सुनते हैं, आज हम कहते हैं हम गाने सुनते भी हैं और गाने देखते भी हैं. बिकॉज विजुअल्स प्ले एन इम्पॉर्टेंट रोल टुडे, वीडियोस हैव कम बिकम द ऑर्डर ऑफ द डे. तो आपको लगता है विजुअल्स आल्सो एनहांस द म्यूजिक ऑफ अ फिल्म?
विजुअल्स कैन डेफिनेटली हैव इट हैज अ पावर बट नॉट इंडिपेंडेंटली. इट कांट सर्वाइव विदाउट अ ग्रेट सॉन्ग. If you have a mediocre song also, it could help it. You have a great song and great visuals. It's right. Nothing like it.
Very true. Okay, agar Mumbai music directors ki baat kare to, who are the people whom you think have the potential to make it big in the international market?
A lot of people, like, I can't pinpoint, but most of them have very good reviews we see on the net, like whether Shankar Ehsaan Loy or Vishal Shekhar or Vishal Bharadwaj and Salim Salama and even Ranjit Barot. Now I've been working with Ranjit Barot. A lot of people have great talent and great musicality in them. And I want all of them to become really big. And it's our time now.
Yes, very true.
Even Kailash Kher has been touring the Hollywood Bowl and all those places. People have been saying, oh, Kailash was here. He had a concert. And so it's a great thing to expand the culture into other territories.
Final words in blue. How would you rate your work in this film? Aapko lagta hai ki ye aapki amongst the best soundtracks hai.
Blue is I never say anything the best. It's not my usual cup of tea, but I've had fun doing it because it's an action film. I never do, most of the films I do is patriotic and love and very intense films. And so doing Blue was definitely a different experience. And it's not only the songs, but also the PG, which has a lot of interesting ideas, I guess.